Alright, hey guys, AnimeWestReacts here. This is going to be a reaction to Lucifer and the Biscuit Hammer, episode 11. Hope y'all enjoyed this reaction. If you do, then make sure to like the video, share it, subscribe to the channel, check out the links down below to my Twitter, Twitch, and Discord. And yeah, let's get into this in 3, 2, 1, and play. Yeah, we see it in the dad. We haven't seen the mom yet. But yeah, so last episode was... I actually recorded that one, the other part of that earlier, but pretty good one. We got everyone, or all the knights, going to the beach, just kind of hanging out. Just kind of, we're hanging out there until, one of the seventh, I guess, golem appeared. Sia and the Snake Knight happened to overhear Yuhi and Samidare talking about destroying the world, so she's kind of conflicted. Well, obviously she can't tell everyone about that, for fear of them just eliminating her for knowing. That's one reason. But yeah, we got that happening. Got the Hexatome Bion appearing, and Anima coming and grabbing Yuhi, and he grabs Yuhi and Samidare and takes them away. So the other knights have to win the battle on their own. The Asahina family. Okay. That's something. Trading. Actually, so you get a shocking. Yeah, power to create golems. Oh. Yeah. Okay. Mon dogs. Primary weapons is the tail. Montag. Monday. Here's the names of the seasons. All right. Even if it's lightweight. Yep, he's amazing. You came to play too. Play. Yeah, well. All random and haphazard. All right. Well, power is decent. That look, though. Okay. Well, yeah. Yeah, cover yourself up. But yeah. Running away from home. Yeah, that opposite thing happening. Nosebleed. But yeah. And no trouble, in fact. The look. Okay. Alrighty. So yeah, let him stay here while her stay over there, I guess. Okay. Her aunt. Yep. Still don't want to talk to him. Understandable. Given his past with his grandpa, I think it's understandable. For him to be apprehensive. Perfectly normal. Trying to use the golems to not have to think about stuff. Think about his problems. Okay. Anima. Manima. Still interesting with the sisters seeing it. Little Sami. Didn't want to go in there. Well. All right. Training. Wait until he tires himself out. And if it's smaller. Okay. So, well. Oh, there's nice. Okay, well. Both of them. Yep, she has lost it. Probably. Here we go then. Just go and ask her directly. Not as much of a child as you think she is. Forget to smile. Yeah. smile. Yeah, not bad. Sound like Akitani. Just imitated them. On another drink. All right. Yeah, well. Sleepwalking. Very nice. All right, so yeah. Well, of course, it's not your fault. Damn, difficult things. You're following her. Wants to be left alone, but seeking help. Like that little detail there of trembling. Jump in the river. Well, he did it. Jumped it. Look at the song. Oh yeah, real nice. Kind of adult doesn't hide our feelings. Well, that's good. Alrighty. Oh yeah, gotta do it too. I like that. That was nice. Alrighty, so yeah, I don't know what appears. So yeah, pretty good episode. We got a lot of family drama between Sami and her sister. Sami, her sister, and their mom, because their mom's a famous doctor. She is always working, and so because she has to work a lot, that means that she doesn't get to spend time a lot with her children. And so at one point, when Sami was sick, she had, like, passed out and had to, the mom couldn't visit her because she had to work. And so, yeah, at one point she was, like, unconscious for a week, and the mom apparently couldn't go to see her daughter because she was constantly having to get swamped with work. We also have Sami's sister seemingly speaking to Anima somehow, which is interesting. We'll have to see what happens next. But yeah, leave a like, comment on the video, subscribe for more anime reaction reviews and manga reviews, check out the links down below to my Twitter, Twitch, and Discord. And I will see you all for the next episode. So yeah. See y'all then. Spirit Anima and the Beast Knights. So yeah, later.